couple years ago, I quit my day job and became a full-time independent filmmaker. The first real project I made was a short film called Good Life. And in it, a recently divorced and financially struggling dad takes his daughter out for a fancy dinner for her 10th birthday. And I played the dad. And my 10-year-old daughter, Harriet, played the daughter.
Well, you know, one of the things is you get some you get two birthdays. It's like you got two. You got this one and another one. I can't beat it.
It was great because she'd recently been turned down for the special drama group at school, and the whole experience just felt like a big win for her. After Good Life, Harriet went on to appear in three more of my films. Dobra Ochka, another short film that was set during World War II. Then a feature-length family drama called Get Better. And most recently, a showbiz comedy about a bunch of no-name filmmakers on a quest to find Bill Murray. Cinema Purgatorio.
What's so yeesh? Actor drama, Brie and Nick.
What do you know about Brie and Nick?
Enough.
Okay, well, you know, I'm just gonna lose custody. That's all. Let's get another, back to one!
And it's like watching those films, I see my daughter grow up, and each of those movies feature a father-daughter relationship as part of the plot. And my wife Emily and I, we like to say that we pretty much just make father-daughter movies. There's something special about fathers and daughters that I don't think we see a lot at the movies. Something that's very powerful. Something that's complicated but wholesome. Last summer, when we were filming Cinema Purgatorio, we noticed that Harriet's leg lump had gotten big. For a few months previous, we'd been monitoring what our family doctor thought was a cyst near her right knee, the leg lump. But it was no big deal, no cause for alarm. These things happen in growing teenagers. It'd probably go down by the end of the summer. But it didn't. It grew. And after we wrapped the film and Harriet began her eighth grade year, we found out that it was cancer. Myxoid Liposarcoma, to be exact. It's a very rare kind of cancer for young people, and it's deadly because it starts contained. It's kind of like a tumor sac in one of the extremities, but it jumps. We don't know how or why, but sarcomas jump to the liver and the stomach, the lungs. Suddenly, my 13-year-old daughter was sick. Like the kind of sick that kills otherwise healthy people. Harriet had cancer. Cancer kind of sneaks up on you. I mean, I'm not trying to alarm you. I'm just saying it's a surprise, like every single time. And our surprise came this time last year, October 2013.
I want a trip inside your head. Spend a day there. Hear the things you haven't said and see what you might see. I wanna hear you when you call. Do you feel anything at all? I wanna see your thoughts take shape.
My dear friend Robert Linder, who had starred in Get Better with me and Harriet, had developed a brain tumor just before we started shooting that film in October of 2011. Now, Robert, I mean, he's Robert. So he insisted that the show go on. He started radiation treatments the very first day of shooting, and he was still fighting brain cancer when the film premiered in July of 2012. Robert lost his fight a year later. He actually passed on the day we wrapped shooting Cinema Purgatorio. As sad and devastating as that was, when my daughter was diagnosed, there is a sense that God has left the building. It's just like all hope has vanished. But you fight. If you truly believe in hope and truth and beauty and life, you fight. Just when you quit, I am you, you are mine. Love makes nonsense of space and time will disappear. Love and logic keep us clear. Reason is on our side. Love, the songs are in your eyes. I see them when you smile. I've had enough of romantic love. I give it up, yeah, I give it up for a miracle. A miracle drug. A miracle drug. Harriet's family and her doctors, we made a plan. Chemo would be part of that plan, to shrink the size of the tumor. Radiation treatment would not. Harriet was still growing. There would be then a surgery to remove the tumor. And if this worked, and if we could prevent that dreaded jump and purge her body of the cells that were trying to kill her, she'd survive. I was terrified. We all were. Harriet, one night late, she was up on the computer shopping for wigs. There was a week there when an MRI suggested that the cancer may have jumped. The spot, I think it was near her pancreas, was biopsied and found to be completely benign. It was a tiny little cyst she'd probably had since she was a baby. But there was a full week and a half or so when it could have, you know, the worst. I was directing a web series episode that week, or trying to. And the producers were very kind, but honestly, I could barely stand for the dread and fear that completely clouded my head and heart. Every day, I drive to and from the studio listening to the same song, Miracle Drug by U2. And it became my prayer. Like, I would sing and cry and pray that song over and over. And there's a line in it where it says, "Beneath the noise, below the din, I hear a voice. It's whispering. In science and in medicine, I was a stranger. You took me in." And something clicked. I'm a screenwriter, and I thought, we need a rewrite. I called Harriet's surgeon and said, "You know, you're the smartest guy ever. I'm some guy shooting a Star Trek movie in Georgia. But you, man, you are for real. But I do have imagination, creativity. I can look at problems from unique perspectives. So my ask is," and this is after we found out the little cyst was benign, "I asked if he thought we could get that tumor out of my daughter's leg, like now, pre-chemo. Just go in, get the whole thing, cure her cancer without ravaging her body with chemical drugs." And he said, "Yeah, I think I can." So we went back to the team and we recalibrated our plan. And on Tuesday, November 12th, Dr. Porter was going straight to the front lines of this battle with cancer. He was gonna get the damn thing out. The afternoon before that surgery, we had a farewell tumor party at the house. Harriet, her friends, family, everybody showed up to send off this malignancy in style. And as I look back on it, I'm struck with just how much support Harriet and all of us had. I mean, many kids and families with the same diagnosis don't have that. We had great insurance that paid for Harriet's medical care. We have a family who helped out with extra costs and unexpected financial burdens. I mean, really, we all felt so safe as we had this staring contest with death. But again, that's not everybody's story, nor is the result of our fight typical.
Well, a year ago, I had cancer, and my doctor, Dr. Porter, operated on my leg and took it all out. So as of a year ago, I am completely sarcoma free. So 4 MRIs and I'm all clear.
Last Thanksgiving was really meaningful for our family. Harriet was recovering fully in her bed at home that day.
That was not so fun. It included a lot of laying around and doing nothing all day, but I was happy.
Sometimes I tell people that my youngest daughter, Harriet, had cancer for a month once, and it nearly killed me. And that's actually kind of flippant. I mean, the truth is, it could have killed her. But that's just not the kind of father-daughter story I ever wanted to tell. So we fought against it. And somehow, by the grace of God, she was spared.
Check out sarcomawarriors.org. This foundation, started by my surgeon, Dr. Porter, raises funds that are directly given to the people who need them the most, people who are literally fighting for their lives.